Thanks, Eric. It's always great to be back here at the MIF, talk to the investor. So I'm going to just give a quick overview of what we've done over the last few months. A lot of you have seen this story before, and give you an idea of where we're going next here. Of course, forward-looking statements. About Aston Bay, two main projects, as Eric mentioned, still only gives me 10 minutes to talk, but we'll do the best we can here. Our original project that we've been talking about for a couple of years now is our Aston Bay project, located on Somerset Island in Nunavut. What we're looking for here is large, high-grade, sediment-hosted copper and zinc deposits. You can think of this, you know, in terms of those Congo-style deposits, Kamoa Kakula, Kipushi, bringing the zinc story in, and Polaris as well. We're located just south of the Cominco's former Polaris mine. New project for us, just in the last year or so, is the Blue Ridge project located down in Virginia. Again, in the sort of the same wheelhouse of copper and zinc, SED-hosted, SEDEX, maybe VMS, copper, zinc, maybe a bit of cobalt. Also, precious metals, always great to be finding gold, and we're very happy to bring that into our wheelhouse here. Big news for us, each project has a world-class mine finder directing the exploration. Up in Nunavut, we have Dave Broughton, Robert Friedland's former VPX at Ivanhoe, still main consultant for them. The guy who found, or was on the team that found Kamoa Kakula, couldn't have a better stamp of approval having that guy helping us out up north. Down in Virginia, we have Don Taylor. Our Virginia projects, this is his former company. We've brought the company into Aston Bay. Don is leading our exploration there. And he, of course, is the guy who found the Taylor deposit for Arizona Mining. His other company was bought by South 32 last year, a great win for the shareholders. So our project in Nunavut, Storm Copper, Seal Zinc. You can see some of the highlights of the mineralization we have here. Tens of meters of multiple percent copper at the surface. On the zinc side, we have a small resource. It's only about a million tons, but it's, again, over 10% zinc, plus about an ounce and a half of silver. Both of these things sitting at the surface. So we really have a very strong indication of some very robust ore-forming systems here on both the copper and the zinc side. And so the real question is how you can find more. And well, we have a conceptual model. I've shown this at this conference before. And really the idea is great mineralization at the surface, flat-lying sediments that can host mineralization. Maybe there's something hidden at depth. And it's been backed by geophysics. We've done some gravity geophysics, and here you can see a gravity anomaly associated with some faults and some mineralization. And you know, to be honest, I've placed this over top of the model here. If I flew a gravity survey over that model, those red potential deposits, this is the exact kind of anomaly you'd expect to find. And so backed by geophysics, that's great. But there's a challenge here, and it's something we've discovered in the last year or so. We originally thought that there was about 400 meters of sediments here hosting this potential mineralization. It looks like it's actually more like 2,000 meters of sediment. That's good and bad. The good side, the sediments, that's a source of the metals. Again, big basin, potential for big deposits and a potential big payoff down the road. But we can't drill 2,000 meters. We need to find something that's within the top 500 meters. That's what we need to do next, and that's what we plan to do up north this summer. Do a geophysical method that can help us get a better control on where those anomalies may lie. And so the idea is go over those anomalies with another geophysical method, an electrical method, look for those anomalies that are within the top 500 meters. Those are the ones we want to hit. Those are the ones that have the potential to really pay off down the road. So moving quick to Virginia. Actually, I was just driving down to Virginia about 2 weeks ago, and I ran across this this plaque here. I don't know if you, for those of you who can't read it, essentially it states that this area of Virginia was the most notable region in the country for gold mining before the California Gold Rush. I didn't know that. It's good to know. You know, people ask, you know, are there any mines here? Is this a region? Yes, it is. This is a very rich region for gold and base metals. So why did we pick up this project in Virginia? It's a great jurisdiction, a great spot to work. We're working on private land, timber farms, working with resource companies. They understand the business. Fee simple jurisdiction, no permitting is required for drilling down there. We can act very quickly. We just drilled, we just signed a project. Four weeks later, we started drilling, first time drilling down in Virginia. We can work very quickly down there. It's a great spot to work. We've been able to pick up some database, Dawn's database and Dawn's expertise here. It's a great spot to do work. Dawn has the experience and the relationships to get work done. And of course, for the company, it's good for the geographic diversity. We can work year round. We're not tied to a seasonal play anymore. And the commodity diversification of gold. It's always nice to bring gold into the mix. So what we have down in Virginia, at the moment, we've signed an agreement for the Buckingham Gold Project, and we have drilled it. You can think of it as an extension of the Avalon Slate in the Carolina gold belts. We have gold-bearing quartz veins at the surface, pretty spectacular. You can see a little spot of gold there. Free gold, free milling gold, should be free milling gold in quartz. Some of the grab samples there are over 700 grams per ton. Again, right at the surface. We have a strike length on that vein where it sticks out of the ground of about 150 meters. We think that sits within a much larger anomaly, and we'll be more news on that to come. But we have completed a six drill hole program, almost 900 meters. Those results are at the lab. You can see, obviously, we do have visible gold in the veins at the surface. When you have that, we have to run a special assay procedure, metal screen, takes a bit longer. We're waiting for those assay results to come back. We hope to have some good hits for both the vein mineralization. We have both vein type of quartz vein mineralization and disseminated mineralization. That's important for us. We see the same thing down at the Hale Gold Mine in just 200 miles to the south in South Carolina. Some of you may remember that from the old Remarco play. It's now an Oceana Gold mine, over 5 million ounces. We think we're seeing very similar type of mineralization there here at Buckingham Gold. Share structure. I think the most important thing to take away from that, if you look at our average volume there, since January, we've had an average volume of almost 750,000 shares per day. That's a lot of eyes on the stock. We think that's a good thing to have, and we're quite happy to have that. Next steps for us, for Blue Ridge, again, we're going to be signing some more agreements. We're going to increase the potential, we think, for the Buckingham Gold Project. As I say, we think it sits within a much larger system. We're actively working on getting that land signed up. It's not just gold, though. Again, base metals potential, copper, zinc, cobalt, plus accompanying precious metals. Don Taylor, again, this was his project. He is quite sold that there is a lot of discovery to be made here. And we're actively looking forward to investigating that for the rest of the year here. Up at Aston Bay, again, do some geophysics, get a feel for where some of these anomalies may lie. We're set, ready to go up there. The camp is in, everything is in place. If we're lucky enough to find a significant anomaly, I can pull the trigger well into June to start a drill program if we deem it's necessary. But the same, while we're working up there, we're going to continue working down in Virginia. Again, looking for both gold and precious metals. I think that's all I really want to say. So thanks for your time. Come drop by the booth. Always glad to tell you more about the story. Thank you.